Hey there everybody, it's AirPirateCid, and welcome back to more Let's Play Pokemon Fire Red! In the last episode, I defeated Giovanni, I defeated my rival, I went into Victory Road with the epic One Piece ending, and I just basically vanished for about 4 or 5 days, so sorry about that. I was abnormally busy, so yeah, that's why I was gone. Anyways, I'm back temporarily, and I'm teaching the King Strength. I'll get rid of Horn Attack. Anyways, the reason why I'm going to go ahead and teach the King Strength is because I don't feel like having a temporary HM Slave, whereas I could be getting everyone experience in this place. And eventually, I'm going to go ahead and teach the King Earthquake anyway, so I'm just going to fly to Fuchsia City off camera, and I'm going to go to the Move to Leader's house, which is right next to the Pokemon Center, get rid of Strength, and then teach him Earthquake. And I keep forgetting that you run into random battles in this place because repels don't work if your levels are not higher than the random Pokemon in the area. And also, you see that wall right above me, right there, that's just kind of blocking that little path? Yeah, watch what happens whenever I press this boulder on the switch. It's gone somehow. I don't know where it went to, but it doesn't really bother me. And I ran into a female trainer. Well, hello, good looking. What are you doing in this place all by yourself? Oh, wait, of course, your Pokemon trainer. Or your Pokemon training. Anyways, aside from that little whatever it was, I'm not going to show every single fight that I run into in this place with trainers, just because, as you've already seen, Naomi here has 5 Pokemon. All of the trainers here have at least 4 or 5 Pokemon in their party, and yeah, that would just take way too long to actually record, and it would run up the 15-minute time limit on YouTube. Come on, Surf, kill it. You butthole. Oh well. Alright, here we go. One more Surf, and you are out of here, Persian. Bye-bye. Oh crap, I just got 666 experience. That's not good. I think that the devil's taking over my game. Oh well. Alright, Ponyta should be no problem. One more Surf will easily dispose of you. Anywhom, whenever I have been gone for the past few days, I really haven't had any time to go off-screen training, right? Or I have not had any time to go do any off-screen training. Right now, my grammar is just kind of lame. I don't know why, but anywho, yeah, so after I finish up with Victory Road, I'm going to go ahead and then that's whenever I will do my off-screen training. And I don't even know why I'm talking so funny right now, or it feels like I'm talking funny. I don't really know. Yay! Rock Slide killed made Rapidash faint. Of course, that was it. And against Vulpix, the same thing will happen. Rock Slide. Because ZT player is very... Ah, no, it missed. That sucks. Oh well, at least Imprison failed. Because I forgot what Imprison does. I think it... If you and your opponent have some of the same moves, and if you use Imprison, your opponent cannot use them. So, if you knew, like, Flamethrower, and if your opponent knew Flamethrower, and if you used Imprison, then your opponent cannot use Flamethrower for as long as you're out there. I think that's how it works. I'm not really sure. Come on, Rock Slide. Do the job. Yay! I love you, ZT player. And yay, 3,024 Pokédollars. Alright, now, you see this boulder up here? Yeah, just keep pushing it on to the left. I mean, I'm gonna come back off camera and get the other item, which is a rare candy, but I want the Dragon Claw TM for right now. The rare candies I never use, so yeah. And also, if you go back up there, you could grab a full restore. I almost forgot about that. And I almost forgot about the random battles. Stop running into things, God. And I did not feel the need to show that fight either. Okay, moving on. You see this boulder right here? Ignore it. What you're gonna wanna do is go down here, push the boulder onto that switch over there so we can continue on throughout Victory Road. And speaking of Victory Road, if you are playing the original red, blue, or yellow, then what you might notice is that... I'm sorry, I had a brain fart, but what you might notice is that Moltres... Okay, I just cut out that fight, but what I was trying to say is, Moltres is in Victory Road in Red, Blue, and Yellow. However, in the remakes of Fire Red and Leaf Green, they added the Sevi Islands, and they put Moltres on one island, where it's at Mount Ember. And let's see what this item is. A full heal. Alright, we can use that later. And I do not want to fight you. And I don't want to fight you. Please don't see... Wow, he didn't see me. Alright. And I got... the TM7, which is hail. And hail, as most of you who are watching this should know, hail is a weather type attack that makes it hail, and if you're ice type, then you will not be affected by it. Otherwise, you'll get hit for damage. Yes, I am that child prodigy. Or maybe it's Ness. I don't really know. I think this is the third or fourth video in a row that I have made an Earthbound reference. Oh well, doesn't really matter to me. Let's go ahead and use Aurora Beam. Hopefully that will one-shot you. Also, another thing I just now realized is that that first trainer that I fought in this place, who was named Naomi, I'm surprised I didn't make a Death Note reference and call her Naomi Misora. Until now, that is. No! Damn you and damn your Hyper Potion! Come on, Aurora Beam. Get a critical hit. Critical hit. Ah, of course not. I didn't know that that attack actually lowered attack. I really never knew that Aurora Beam lowered attack. I always thought that it, like, either lowered speed or defense or something like that. Oh, well, there's my critical hit, of course. Whenever I record my videos, my critical hits always happen whenever I don't need them. Which I'm pretty sure that's pretty commonplace whenever people record their Let's Plays for any RPGs and they get a critical hit whenever they don't need it. Go, Jongo! See, how can we obliterate you, Electrode? We will obliterate you with Psychic. Ah, no, you got a critical hit too. That's not good. Alright, Psychic. Bye-bye, Electrode. It's been nice knowing you. Which, actually, I'm kind of surprised that I'm faster than you. But then again, I am holding the Quick Claw, so that does make sense. And against Arcanine, I will send out ZT Player because, well, ZT Player needs some more spotlight time. And also, I'm trying to train him up. I forgot that Intimidate lowered my attack by one stage. Now, the way that whenever you raise your speed or lower attack or raise defense or something like that, you can raise or lower each and every one of your stats by 6 stages from the initial starting point. And I believe that if you raise it or lower it to the maximum, like if you raise your attack by 6 stages, I believe it doubles your attack. I'm not really sure how it works. Either that or it does it by like 3 times. I'm not really sure how that whole entire mechanics worked for that. But I don't feel the need to do any research for it. So if you want to find out more about it, then just like Google it or something. Or go to SciPoke or Cerebee.net. And if you're wondering what those two websites are, I'll go ahead and I'll just put them in the description. And against a Sandslash, I will send out Awkwafina, who I still have been calling Vaporeon. I don't even know why. Alright. Ah, crap, I forgot that I didn't have any Surf. Oh well, we can still use Aurora Beam, which is just as super effective. Yay! One-shotted Sandslash. I love you, Awkwafina. That means that you don't get beaten tonight. Yes, the rumors are true. I am that child prodigy. And I kicked your ass for a max revive. Alright, that was very, very well worth it. Alright, let's use one more max repel, even though they're essentially useless right now. You see this boulder right here? No, I don't want to use strength yet. All right, you're going to push that boulder down here and onto that switch right there. And I'm going to go ahead and grab this item, which is overheat. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and push that boulder off screen really quick. So I'll be right back. Alright, there we go. I wasn't really sure whenever I was going to do that editation, but chances are it probably came out all screwed up. Oh well, it doesn't really matter as long as, you know, I went ahead and I cut on ahead. Whenever you press that switch there, yes, you can run up here. Yes, ignore that boulder for right now, but you can run up here and run into this trainer. Which is just like the other trainers in here, and she used, about 5 Pokemon, all of which were pretty decent leveled. And we're going to use yet another Max Repel. Alright, moving on. Don't see me, don't see me, don't see me. Thank you! Now you're going to push this boulder down this hole right here. And then after that, you're going to fall down the hole yourself. And you're going to push that very same boulder onto the switch right here. So, I'm going to do that really quick. Alright, we did that, and we can go up here, which means that we can leave Victory Road, finally. Or at least I think we can. Wait, don't see me, don't see... Wow, I was just like one step away from you and you didn't see me. You must be blind or something, man. Oh well. Alright, now that we're out of Victory Road, that means that I am almost done with my episode. Hooray! Alright, now that we're up here, yes, I want to heal my Pokemon so badly. Thank you, Nurse Joy. I love you too. Alright, and then after that, we're going to go see what the item shop has right here. Alright, we could get some full restores, but I don't really want to buy anything right now. Alright, well now. Yes, from this point on, we will be fighting the Elite Four. Thank you all for watching. In the next episode, I will return stronger. So, I will see you there.